So the journey begins. 1300 kilometers in 15 hours. As the helicopter left us, we started to set up camp. Finding a flat spot without rocks for your tent is an impossible task. But we did all right. No complaints of back pain during the 3 nights we spent with this camp. As the tent was in place, we went down to the stream to see if we could food some fish. We got down, and she ran low, lower than usual. But despite the wind, we managed to catch a few grayling. We had some food and coffee. Then, as the evening came upon us, the wind died down and the fish started to rise. Me and Lilith went down to a small lagoon where we have had some great fishing the years before. We struggled for a while, even retreating to nymphs. But then we found a few fish, eating just under the surface.
Ta den utanför dig. Där är han. Han är i alla fall hungrig den där gången. Good job, Ben.
I
The next day, we had decided to take a stroll downstream, where we never ventured before. We caught a few nice grayling, which surprised us a little, since this felt like prime trout territory. We got back to camp rather late and got a fire going. We had dinner, and then, just as the day before, the wind started wearing out, and the fish started eating just below the surface. It didn't take long until Andres was hooked up to a nice grayling. The last day on this river, the wind was a real issue. Me and Lilis went downstream again, throwing big meat on heavy sinking lines, hoping to catch some nice trout. We fished for several hours with only one small trout to show for it. But then, all of a sudden, Lilis was hooked up to a nice trout.